Hi, I'm Anisha Willafort.
And I'm Jessica Hunt. We're here with the Kiwanis News team at Arthur Ashe Stadium.
Today we're going to be covering the Charles Pasarell U.S. Open press conference. Hi, we're here at the U.S. Open press conference, and I'm Anisha Willafort, and I'm here with
Dr. Blash from Communities and Schools, the executive director.
Okay.
And I'm Jessica Hunt. We're here with the Kiwanis News team, and I'm here with...
Hey, Jessica. I'm Jeb Bush. I'm the governor of the state of Florida. How you doing?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm great. I'm having a fun time here at the United States Tennis Center. I wish I could stay to watch the tournament, but we're here to unveil a really exciting program called First Serve, and Florida's going to be one of the places where more of these First Serve centers are going to be built, at least in the first part of the program.
Okay.
This program, could you tell us more about it?
Sure. You want me to hold this or you want to hold it? Okay, great. First Serve is a partnership with Communities and Schools, which has a big presence, just like here in New York. Communities and Schools has a big, big presence in our state of Florida, with the United States Tennis Association, which is the organizing body for tennis in our country, the state of Florida, and private corporations and the city governments, where we're going to refurbish parks, tennis facilities in the urban core areas that are kind of languish. You know, sometimes these places aren't well kept up. We're going to refurbish them, put new tennis courts in them so that they're state of the art. Billie Jean King's Foundation is going to have these really cool backboards. I haven't seen them, but I've been told about them. They're really, really neat, so young people will get excited about playing tennis. We're going to have computer centers at the parks where young people can come and do their homework or learn about how to use technology, how to use computers, and they're going to have mentors with the help of the Communities and Schools. So the combination of all this will be a safe learning environment where kids will be able to learn how to play tennis. And the tennis part's really, really neat because I think out of this effort, a new United States tennis U.S. Open champion will probably come. And I don't know who it's going to be, but I'd like to meet them before they do it. It'd be kind of neat, don't you think? Yeah. You guys play tennis?
Yes. Okay, that's great. I think that's a real good program. And how do you feel about the game of tennis?
Well, I think it's great, and we're going to try to certainly put a First Serve tennis program in Ocean Hill, Brownsville, where your school is. You're going to be the first one in New York City. And we promise to do it.
First time anybody's heard that promise right now?
That's right now. It's the first time. And you get it because you deserve it.
Okay.
That's news. I mean, you just made news right now. That's the first time anybody's heard that. So, good work, reporters.
Dr. Blash, what are you here for?
I'm here to represent the 63,000 children in communities and schools in District 23, District 4, District 6, and 31 New York City public high schools. And we're here to bring exactly what Governor Bush talked about, mentors and caring adults into your lives so that you can have the direction to really make something of your own lives. And that's our purpose.
Can I ask a question? Where'd you get those cool nails?
A place in Brooklyn.
Brooklyn?
A place in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
That's pretty neat.
Thank you very much. Your ball is pretty neat, too.
You can have it.
Oh, cool. Thank you.
Worth it.
It wasn't mine to give, but you can have it.
All right.
Well, thank you all very much. See ya. KWN.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Take care.
Really appreciate it.
It's nice meeting you all.
Hi, I'm Anisha Willafort, and I'm here with
Charlie Pasarell.
Okay, hi. I would like you to tell us, what is it that you do?
Well, I've been involved in the sport of tennis for many, many years. I run a tennis tournament in California, but I used to play tennis. I played here at the U.S. Open for many years. I went to college, and actually went to college with my college roommate at school was Arthur Ashe, and Arthur Ashe and I played for UCLA, and we won the NCAA championship. So I've been involved in the sport of tennis all my life.
Like, how old are you? Are you very young when you started?
Oh yeah, I was when I started playing tennis. I must have been just over 8 years old, and my mom and dad played a little tennis, and so I was kind of exposed to tennis, and so I liked it. I liked it from the first time I hit the first tennis ball, and I always wanted to play tennis, and I've played tennis all my life.
Okay, who was like a player that you admired when you were younger? Is there anyone that you admired?
Well, that's a very easy question, and actually, the guy that probably have the greatest admiration, and it's a very, very quick answer, is Arthur Ashe. Arthur, I had the privilege of being his close friend, roommate at college, but Arthur was a great inspiration to all of us, and he was a great leader, and somebody that did more than just play good tennis. You know, he really, really cared about his friends. He really cared about people, and he did so much more than it was asked of him to do. And so, because of him, I mean, when you talk about sports heroes, there are very, very, very few sports heroes ever. A hero is somebody that goes, that does more, that puts himself at risk to help other people. And Arthur Ashe fits that category. He was a hero because he really did. He put himself at risk to help other people, and not too many good athletes or too many great champions do that. They're great stars, they're celebrities, but a hero is somebody that's a little bit. And Arthur Ashe is probably one of the great sports heroes. So that's a very easy question to answer. Arthur Ashe, without a doubt.
Okay. Do you have any favorite players now that's in the game?
Oh yeah, I have a lot of them. Starting from Pete Sampras and Andre Agassi in men's tennis, to Venus and Serena Williams, and Lindsay Davenport, Martina Hingis. Then we got some real young players coming up, like Andy Roddick. I think everybody's hoping, and I hope he does take over from Pete and Andre when Pete and Andre get too old to play on the tour. So there's a lot of exciting tennis players out there. Guga from Brazil, he's also very exciting. He's a terrific tennis player. There's many good players from Spain, from South America, and so there's a lot of great tennis players.
Okay, since like we like tennis and we want to know, that is there any way that we can meet Venus and Serena Williams?
Well, I hope so. Yeah, I think there should be a way for you to be able to meet Venus and Serena. They're very nice people, and they're very accessible to people. Obviously, they're busy playing their matches right now. But I think, if we can ask the right people here at the U.S. Open that you want to try to do that, they probably can make sure they get you to them. We need to ask the people here from the tournament about, if you can meet Venus and Serena. They're really nice. I mean, once you meet them, you'll agree with me. They are really nice.
Okay, thank you for your time.
Thank you, Anisha.
Welcome. Hi, I'm Anisha Willaford, and
I'm Jessica Hunt, and we're here with the KWN News team, and
I'm Bill Milliken, founder and president of Communities and Schools nationally.
So, Bill, why are you here today?
I'm here because we're part of the partnership that's going to launch this first serve around the country, starting in Florida and Vegas and some other places.
Okay, so did you enjoy what has happened so far?
Oh, very much so, because I think this is going to give a lot of young people a chance to learn the game of tennis, and some of them may go on to be great tennis players, others it's just a great sport, but they're also going to get introduced to some great education tools.
So have you ever played tennis before and won a match?
No, not me. I kind of grew up without that, and that's one of the reasons I want to see other young people have a chance at it, because I didn't.
Okay, how do you feel about the game tennis?
I think tennis is a great game. It's nonviolent. It shows a lot of people working very hard to accomplish something that has a lot of skill to it. But I also like it because anybody can play it. You don't have to be.
Okay, can you tell us, like, what is it that you do?
I'm sorry.
Can you tell us what is it that you do?
Yeah, I help spread Communities and Schools around the country. Communities and Schools is an organization that makes sure that whatever young people need at school, resource-wise, is delivered right there to the school, whether it's a mentor, a tutor, or glasses, or whatever it is, so that they can succeed in their studies.
Okay, and do you plan to, like, put tennis programs inside of schools?
Well, in after-school programs, you know, in partnership with schools, but after the school day is over.
Okay.
How long do you plan for, like, the tennis programs to go on, from, like, 3 o'clock to how long?
Well, you know, I think it's best if it can be, like, from 3 till 9, because some of it will be tennis, but other parts of it will be working on computers and getting tutoring and helping take care of some of the study needs that are necessary in order to graduate and succeed.
So when you say working on computers, you mean like going on different sites, getting ready for college, and just helping you to understand computers more so you'll be ready for your work life as you get older?
Yeah, and I've noticed in some of the centers that I've worked in after school, and that sometimes the kids can bring their parents in and teach them computer and get them on it if they don't have it at home.
So this is not only a program for children, it's a program for families as well?
Yeah, it's going to start with the young people, but in the evening we certainly want families involved with the young people.
So have you ever met Venus and Serena Williams?
No, I haven't. I got to see Serena play last night, though. That was such a thrill.
Was she good?
Oh, she was phenomenal. Just phenomenal. She had gotten ahead, then fell behind, and then made a big comeback and came through in the end.
Okay, I would like to ask you, where do you get the idea of this program that you're starting?
Well, I got in trouble when I was younger and kicked out of school, high school. And it was a caring adult on the streets that helped me out, got me off the streets and back in school, and gave me a chance in life. And that's why I say that it's relationships that change people, not the programs themselves. If it wasn't for a caring adult, I wouldn't be around today.
Okay. Thank you for your time.
Great job.
Nice Thank you.
You both have wonderful smiles, too.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Hi, I'm Anisha, and I'm here with
Jessica Hunt, and we're from the KWN News team, and we're here with
Richard Williams.
And Richard Williams, could you please explain who you are?
Well, I'm not too sure who in the hell I am, but I am. you got me by surprise there. But they tell me I'm a good friend of everyone. So I've done some things to try to help tennis and myself as well, and I trained Venus and Serena Williams, along with the help of my wife.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I would like to ask you, how does it feel to be a father of two motivated young people?
It feels very good when I first started, but now it's so difficult because you run it from one girl to the next girl, and everyone coming up to you. It's kind of it's pretty rough. It's not the type of glamour life that I think people see me doing, because I have so many things that I have to do. But it's pretty rough. But at the end of the day, we hope we get the job done.
Okay. What age did you start? Did your daughter started playing tennis?
Venus, I started her first. She started 4 years, 6 months, and one day. And after about a month, we stopped her for a year because she loved it too much. She didn't want to study the books, so we stopped her. And we had to let her understand that it's okay to be a good tennis player or anything in sports, but you don't want your life to end there, because if it ends there, you're going to be at the end of the road, and you probably live 75 years, and you have 50 years to live as a fool. So we stopped and had to convince Venus that this thing is serious, not tennis, but her education as well as family and God.
Did Serena and Venus ever bicker over, like, tennis or just certain stuff?
No, I have never seen anyone like Venus and Serena. We have quite a few kids in our home, too. But they are so close to each other. And one of the main reasons they probably never bickered or flickered with each other is because I brought them up the way my mom and dad brought me up back in the, the 40s and the 50s. And we was taught that family is the oldest human institution in the world. And that's the way we ran it. Everyone had to look out for the next person. And they are so close, it's unreal. Matter of fact, they approached me to write a book called Sisters Love.
Okay, do you think one day maybe we can interview your daughters?
I really think my daughters would be very lucky if you would take the time out to interview them. I think what you're doing is a little bit more important than what they're doing right now, because you're planning a major league career, and their career is going to end here pretty soon, won't be long. So I'm sure they would love for you to interview them, yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Have a great day.
Hi, I'm Jessica Hunt, and I'm with the KWN News team, and I'm here with
Sam Lloyd.
Bill Beasley.
So, Sam Lloyd, what are you doing here today?
Well, we actually work for Star Sports, which is a network that goes out across Asia with more than 100 million viewers. And we're here with Phil, my cameraman, doing lots of different features about various aspects of the US Open, from the merchandise to what people eat when they come here, to the court surface, to fitness, you name it, we've done it.
Okay. So what part do you do? What part do you play in this today?
Okay, I'm the cameraman, so I have to make sure all the audio, all the pictures all look good and all that sort of stuff, and make sure Sam looks pretty on TV.
So what do you do today?
Well, already we went to the new fitness center that's opened here at the US Open for the players. It's called the Equinox Gym. We went to see the women's number one, Martina Hingis, training. We saw Sandrine Testu, the French girl, and also Byron Black, who's very much a double specialist. So we caught up with them training at the Equinox Gym, and also just did a couple of interviews as well about the new facilities.
So any of you interested in tennis when you were younger?
Yeah, I used to play when I was younger, and now I play socially. I really enjoy the sport, and I cover Wimbledon every year, and now this is my first time at the US Open, so it's a great opportunity to come here at Flushing Meadows.
So what about you?
Well, I never actually played tennis when I was at school, but I actually come from Australia. So we play Australian rules football, so I was more into that side of it. I like football and more of that sort of sports, surfing and all that sort of stuff. So.
Okay, so what other sports are you into?
Well, I'm a sports broadcaster, so I cover all different sports, but I love rugby, which is obviously a very British game. You don't get much of that in America. Cricket, athletics, motorsport. I love rallying, which again is very popular over in Britain. So I like all sports, actually.
So have you interviewed anybody really important today?
Today, we haven't interviewed any of the players. We've let them get on with what they need to do, preparing for the matches. We're just doing some colour pieces on various aspects of the US Open, just talking to people who are here, just here for a good day out and watch some good action.
Come on, Sam. Tell them, though, about how you almost ran into Pete Sampras out the front of the toilets before.
Yeah, that's actually quite funny. I forgot about that. I was waiting outside the men's locker rooms to interview the guy who's in charge of the locker room, and a door opened from behind. And I turned round and I went smack into Pete Sampras, which is quite funny. And I just went, I was just like a look. I was frozen because I couldn't believe it was him.
So did you get an interview with him?
No, Phil just went, sorry, Pete, in his Australian accent. And we just let him go and get on with what he needs to do.
He's got the match tonight. It's a bit sort of, you can't really interview too many of the players the day of the match. You've got to wait till sort of the next day after they've won or something like that. Because they like to, you know, they like to get prepared and all that sort of stuff as well. Yeah.
So aside from being a cameraman and, you know, preparing, making sure she looks pretty on TV and everything, what is your job complicated in any way?
It's very busy. It's very busy. It's complicated as such that you got to think about a lot of different things. You can't sort of turn your back on things. You've got to be watching things at all times. You've got to be aware of what's around you, even though you're sort of looking straight down the lens, you know. But you've also, it's things like that. So it's not so much hard. You just get, it's like second nature, if you know what I mean. It's really sort of, you just get so used to doing it that it's not such a hard job anymore. But it's very busy and very strenuous.
Okay, this is a question for me. Aren't you too hot?
We've actually got used to it. I mean, Phil comes from Melbourne, Australia, so it's always very hot there. But I come from Britain, where it always rains. So it took me a couple of days to get used to the very humid conditions. But I love the sunshine, and we've been really lucky with the weather this year at the US Open.
This isn't though. In Australia, though, when we do the Australian Open in Australia, it's on court. Like here, it's about, I think it's about 80 or 90 degrees on court. In Australia, it's up around sort of 130 degrees on the actual court. So when we're filming the players and that sort of stuff there, it's really, really hot. You can actually feel your skin just burning. It's just
melting.
Unbelievable. And then Wimbledon's completely different again, because it's always rains.
Just rains all the time in Britain. Yeah.
So aside from the guy who you bumped into today, did you see anybody else?
Yeah, we've seen a lot of players milling about.
This morning.
Yeah, we saw Andre Agassi coming in for a quick warm-up. Saw Venus Williams in the fitness center, and she shied away from the camera. I think she just wants to focus on her matches today. But we've seen a lot. You had a chat with Pat Rafter the other day, didn't you? Before he was knocked out.
Yeah.
Obviously a firm favorite with the ladies, Pat Rafter. But yeah, we've seen a lot of the players milling about. This is what's so great about the US Open compared to other Grand Slam tournaments. It's access to the players, because it's such a relaxed atmosphere here at Flushing Meadows, you know?
So what made you want to cover this today?
Well, we've been here just covering the whole tournament, really. And from a personal point of view, it's a great opportunity to come to another Grand Slam tournament. Of course, you have Roland Garros in France, you have the Australian Open at the start of the year, Wimbledon in June, and the US Open. And from my point of view, it's just nice to come to another Grand Slam, because they're all so unique, aren't they? They're all different in different ways.
They're all different in a lot of ways. I haven't done Roland Garros before, but I've done like 10 Australian Opens, 6 Wimbledons. This is my 3rd US Open, and they're all different in their own way. In Australia, it's a real party atmosphere, very similar to, say, New York. But in, say, Wimbledon's very much, you're sort of steeped in all this tradition, and it's very, I don't know whether you'd say English pompness. And it's, you know, very much a sort of prim and proper sort of Grand Slam, whereas this is very much a grungy, you know, really cool sort of Grand Slam. And everyone's really friendly and everything like that here. It's good.
So do you two work together often?
No, would you believe this is our first job working together? And I think we're firm friends now, Bees, aren't we? We haven't quarrelled once, and we've had a couple of beers together, and we get on well.
Well, thank you very much. I had a good time.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye.
Hi, we would like to say bye from the PS41 Kit Witness News staff team. And I'm Anisha.
And I'm Jessica.
So, Jessica, tell me what you did today.
I interviewed Jeb Bush, George Bush's brother, and George Bush is the president of the United States, and Jeb Bush is the governor of Florida. And Jeb Bush, he was really nice. He gave me this big tennis ball because I said I liked it, so he gave it to me. And me and you together interviewed Richard Williams, Serena, and Venus Williams' father. He was kind of cool, but he kind of cursed in it. But it was good. And I just had fun. We walked around a little, got hot, ate ice cream, ate a lot of food, talked, laughed. I had a good time. We stayed for the press conference, met a lot of different people, met a lot of people from newspapers and stuff like that. It was a good experience today. And what about you, Nene? What did you do today?
Okay, today, being you interviewed Jeb Bush, George Bush's brother. He's the governor of the state of Florida. And we interviewed Richard Simmons, Venus and Serena. Venus and Serena Williams' father. And today I found out that when Venus Williams started to play tennis, she was only 4 years old. And today we had fun. We ate ice cream and buffalo wings. We walked around. We had really fun, and we covered the press conference. And we got this really cool calendar of all the tennis players.
And you also interviewed Danny Charles.
Okay. And we would just like to say bye.
Bye.
See you later.